So are you tired of getting hated in this 2x2 without any online protection and just getting wrecked all day long? Well, today I have the perfect base for you with perfect online protection and even offline protection. And it has enough storage to store anything you have. So let's get into the base store. You start off at the entrance with a nice airlock and then a lot of tarbox storage for you to get instantly back into action, a workbench research table, and as well the entrance to the bunker area. Spawn yourself into a sleeping bag and then you're into the main core of the base. With your level 3, level 2, a lot of storage space and even a vending machine that protects the tool cupboard. As you can see, the main core area has a lot of storage for you to store anything you might have. On the roof we have a turret protected exit as well as a nice view from top. If you go up into the sniper tower, we've got a lot of shooting area and a lot of space to store guns and stuff, and even a fast respawn bed for respawning on top and getting back into the action. The bunker is not console compatible yet. You just remove the small tweak roof and then you can get out of the bunker for now. In the nights when you disconnect, then you just place the floor triangle back again and just place your roof triangle and then upgrade it to sheet metal. Then your bunker is set and your base is safe for the night. The footprint of this base is quite small, so you can probably fit it into any area. The space upkeep and build cost is really low, so it's easy for a solo to do it. 1.9k stone, 2.2k metal and 30 HQM. Sanctuary code down in the description below. So let's start off with the starting unit. Just place a triangle down and then surround it with walls and claim the spot by placing the TC. Then place the tool cupboard far into the corner back, place it in the middle of the triangle. And then close the triangle with the doorway and place a wooden door. Place a foundation next to the doorway and then fill it in with walls. Place on a wall frame and then a wooden door and use this area as some starter items like your sleeping bag, boxes and furnaces. Extend the base by a triangle and close that also with a wooden door. This triangle is a nice spot for a level 1 workbench. Next we expand the base again with another square foundation and then close it off. And then fully enclose the base with the last triangle and just wall it off and then place the ladder on the wall just to get out. On top we just close it off, place a half height floor triangle and then a wooden floor triangle on top so that you can edge it out later on. And then close it off with a wooden door or even a sheet metal one if you have. Back inside, place a window frame and that will be the entrance to your bunker. In this small area you can place a research table and a few boxes. On the outside, go place a triangle and a half height wooden floor tile. This will make the placement of the bunker always pretty easy and simple. Close this off and this will act as nice honeycomb in the future. On the inside, place a tweak triangle floor tile and then your roof. Upgrade it to stone and then your base will be set for the night. Now you are completely immune to any door raiding because it has a hard ass bunk. On the outside, go and upgrade the foundation at the tool cupboard to armor it and the wall as well. And then start to close off this with some stone anchor. And then all around the base, start to fill in triangles and fill it in for high quality honeycomb. There is a few places where you're gonna need half height floor triangle tiles. Just keep this in mind as they will be used in the future for box placement inside the bunker. In the front of the base you can place a stone amp just to get easily into the base and out of the base. Just upgrade the back wall to metal, otherwise you can't upgrade it anymore later on. On the second floor you can start to fill in all the walls all around. After you're done with the walls, fill in the roofs again. And then at the front just two doorways. Two sheet metal doors, but In the final stage, this last sheet metal door must be placed into a armored metal door. Just upgrade the ceiling at the back before placing the wall, otherwise you can't be upgrading the ceiling again. Place in a half height floor tile and this will become a nice little box storage area, like this. And then it's time to start to clear out the whole bunker area and make it into the final stage of the bunker area. Get yourself a vending machine and rotate it and place it nicely off into the doorway. Not fully deep, just a little bit out. Just like this is the perfect placement, and then you'll be able to reach your tool cupboard. If you see a rotate mechanism the whole time, just place something into the vending machine and then it won't be able to rotate again. Now it's time to upgrade the hallways on the inside, the sheet metal and the armor. And then also place in a few garage doors in the wall sockets. On the second floor you can place wherever all the furnaces is. Then start to place in stone window frames and then just place your furnaces back and on the inside. In front of the furnaces is the perfect space for your research table and the repair bench, with a few storage boxes in them. At the third window we can place in a large bed or even a small bed there. On the outside of the base, start to upgrade all the stone honeycomb into metal honeycomb. This base is fully metal on the outside, but it's not necessary to upgrade all the ramps and stuff to metal. If there is honeycomb missing, just add some honeycomb in. In the back side of the base, add a stone roof end facing towards the TC area. This will make the height cost a little bit extra. On the roof, you can start to edge it out the roof tile and then start with the roof area. Leave the one roof tile open for a shoot to the sniper area. This is just a little small pot for your turret. To start off with the shooting floor, just place two wall frames on top of each other and then place a few ladders on top. A few walls in a nice triangle and then a few ladders to the top, and then it will be easy to place the next. Don't worry about falling down, it's not that far, you won't kill yourself. The shooting floor is quite easy to build, just a few floors and then just filling everything around with window frames. Filling the roofs all around and then your whole sniper tower is fully built. Fill in all the windows with window frames, bars, whatever you like. In this corner you can fit in nicely two lockers and then a fast respawn bed. Just placing a few large boxes for easy to look much easier down onto the floor. And then just placing your doors and then your whole base is finished and done. If you like this nice little small base, like and subscribe for next bases like this one. That is nice and fully built, packed with bunkers and everything.